And 10 million liters are being smuggled, average at least 10 million. 10 million liters being smuggled outside the country every single day. And Nigeria has to pay for each liter the difference, the market price, the statistics I use, the average crude oil price using the Brent crude spot is $70 per barrel. And the difference at the spot market, the fine product is from 93 cents to 41 cents. And maybe in Nigerian naira is just from 149 to 65 naira. That's the difference that government pays for every single liter consumed within and without Nigeria, that is in the neighboring countries, which is 34 million liters. The difference of 52 cents, which you have to multiply by 34 million liters. In a nutshell, Nigeria spends close to 1.4 trillion naira every year to fund subsidy. Subsidy is, let me just define the subsidy, what the meaning of subsidy, we talk about subsidies. Now, we all agree that we do not refine the needed liters we need in Nigeria. So the only option we have is to import it. But when we go out to buy those liters, we don't buy them at 65 naira. The major marketers usually buy it at a very high cost, which is 149 naira. Each liter is being bought 149 naira. And they bring it to Nigeria and sell it what? 65 naira. So the difference, who will pay it? So the government pays that difference. So multiplying the liters we consume, which is 34 million naira, 34 million liters, by the difference between 149 to 65, that is the real amount of money the government spends, which is 1.4 trillion naira. 1.4 trillion naira is enough to build a very good refinery. In 4 years, you can build a refinery if government can be relieved of this exorbitant and huge amount of money being spent on subsidy. So that we can have refineries working, so that we can have absolute competition in the market, so that the prices of petroleum products can come down. Okay, so we all agree that our refineries are not functioning, there are a lot of corruption, and maybe some of you may not know that a huge corruption in fuel subsidy. Sorry to say, because some people are using that medium to abscond public money. That's why this administration says we have to support, we have to stop this corruption using subsidy. If there is no subsidy, huge amount of corruption will be reduced. That's why the regulation is introduced. What is the regulation? Regulation is when the government removes its total control in the industry. The government has no hand determining the price, supplying the products, in whatever activity in the industry. The market is let alone for private individuals. The government can also come in and spend as individual player to make its own profit, but the floor is open for everybody to participate. And there are no. Doesn't mean that the government will not be involved. The government will be standing there as a referee, just like a football match, where we have two sides playing, but a referee in between. That's the meaning of the regulation. Regulation does not mean government will not be watching and make sure things are going well. The government will be there as a referee to make sure that the individual players are playing their roles according to the rules. And these rules are going to be very, very well simplified. And private individuals will be allowed to own refineries, like bourgeoisies in our country, like Dangote, all of us here, we can contribute our share to build a refinery so that we can have the dividends. So this is the brief definition of the regulation. So why do you need the regulation? Like we've all known that. Like I mentioned earlier, that Nigeria spends 1.4 trillion naira every year. Why can't we leave the government of these unnecessary spending? Because this is something that we can achieve. Because we need to be perseverant, we need to be patient for some little time so that the government can have a relief so that such certain infrastructural activities like construction of roads, the construction of refineries, creation of more job opportunities can be adequately achieved. And also the government can ensure power stable power supply if it is being relieved of 1.4 trillion naira. And also smuggling, the cost we incur from smuggling the liters to neighboring countries will also be cut. And most of international investors may not like to invest in Nigeria because the government has already regulated the price at 65. Because as an individual marketer, I went to maybe Brentford and I bought my liters at 149. And just the government said I must sell it 65 naira. Obviously, I will not come to Nigeria and invest my money. Because there is no profit in that. There is something of Nigerians or human beings. When something is very cheap, we tend to misuse it. Alright, so we have something around here. So thank you. Thank you for introducing. Thank you.
Sorry, my brother, our lecturer. I'm sorry, I just have to interrupt. In our midst, the man that just came in now is our father. He is not a father like other fathers. He is a father that is interested, very much interested in the very meaningful way of bringing up his children. He is one of the fathers we have in the Federal Capital Territory that so many states don't have. He is a man who is respected by most Nigerians resident in the Federal Capital Territory. Many of his mates are somewhere now doing their business, but he's interested in the very good upbringing of his children. This man is no other person but the sitting state chairman of PDP in the Federal Capital Territory. His name is Alhaji Alhassan Gwagwa Galadiman Gwagwa, the indefatigable leader of the party in the Federal Capital Territory. Just step in to say hello to us. Thank you, and he will be leaving again. Thank you. Sorry, Mr. Speaker.
Okay, so before that, like I was explaining, the reasons why we need to regulate our oil industry. I was mentioning about points wasted on precious resources. Obviously, like I said, Nigerians or any other human being have this kind of attitude. When something is very cheap, people tend to misuse it and reverse such resource, no matter how important that it is. Just because petroleum liter is just 65 naira, you see people using so many cars in their houses. 5, 10 cars, just because the fuel is very cheap. And embarking on unnecessary journeys because the resource is very cheap. So I think we need to have conservation in terms of using the resource. And by virtue of making it a bit relatively higher than the 65 naira, people tend to have conservation in terms of using the oil resource. And another importance of the regulation is that
We all of us rely on oil. We do not look for alternative. And we all agree that this proven reserve we have is going to expire or be exhausted in the next 45 years. What resource are we going to use after oil might have been exhausted? Because during our forefathers, there was nothing like oil. What did they use? They lived. They had energy. They had energy resources that they used at that time. So why can't we think of an alternative resource other than oil? But if it continues to be cheap, people will not think of solution. Right now, I must have believed that when the price was increased to 140, people must have started thinking of solution to oil. So I think we need to find an alternative energy sources right now. And the regulation is the best way to encourage and support search for alternative energies. And regulation took place in Nigeria, and Nigeria we lived well. In 1960 to 1973, there was a full deregulation, and people at that time knew this. The regulation, when the price of winter was used to buy only any certain amount during that time, maybe I think 5 naira, was just because there was oil boom that time. And Nigeria's problem was not money, but how to spend that money. And that's why that was when the time regulation was introduced, where the price of liters have been fixed at certain levels. So now we are not in that era. Nigeria has a lot of debt. We have been experiencing budget deficit. So why can't we come all together to secure or maybe to find a solution to this problem of economic deficit? So several attempts were made by the government to reduce, maybe to bring regulation, like due to the labor actions it has been maybe halted separately as well. So I'm still going to be very brief. There are steps to regulation which I'm going to skip, because I've just been noticed that I have only 2 minutes to go. And lastly, I would like to also highlight some of the major important reasons why the regulation has to take place. We all agree that if our leader is being regulated a certain amount, the foreign investors will not come in. And it's only when the foreign investors come in that we can have functional refineries working, that we can refine exactly what we need in our country. So the best way is to regulate the sector so that foreign investors, people from Europe, Arab world, can come into Nigeria, help Nigeria and Nigerians to establish these refineries. Because if these refineries have been built, the Nigerians, they will be the ones to be employed in that refineries. So it's just another opportunity to create employment opportunities. Instead of having 4 refineries belonging to the government, why can't we have 10 refineries? And I believe all of us will know how lucrative it is to work in a refinery. If you have a friend working in a refinery, he can tell you how much he earns every month. So if you can have like 10, 20 refineries from foreign investors, we can have thousands of employment opportunities for young people. And the price of petrol liters need to be predictable so that investors can really research the total amount of profit that they can make in a year. Because the price is going to be determined by the interaction of the demand and supply, and which can be forecasted. And some people are thinking that there is going to be loss of job, there is going to be inflation. Yes, there is going to be one, but just temporarily. And I will explain. Now, if I say there is monopoly, I'm the only seller in the market, and I decide to charge you 100 naira, no one can say no. But if I have a competitor, someone next to me, and sells that product at 99 naira, just 1 naira below my price charge, obviously people will continue to patronize his own products, not mine, isn't it? And if I see my neighbor is selling our product at 99 naira, and I'm not getting patronage, I'll obviously have to reduce the price. So at the end, the price of liters may eventually come even lower than 65 liters sometimes. Because even